Hey guys, welcome back. Mark here. Okay, so today I want to start painting a lighthouse scene. This is going to be Nubble Lighthouse in Maine. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start by drawing the scene. And the lighthouse is over here. I'm going to paint in the hill that it's on. It'll be start here and go up. Close here and then down. And then there's another hill. It comes down this way. And it comes down to some rocks and up there. Then we have some. We'll come down here where the water line is. This is where it meets the ocean. Goes up that way. Down that direction. Like that. Comes this way. These are just rock formations I'm drawing in. Little rock formation. And I see little stones here. I'll eventually detail all these as I get further along. Smaller stones. The water area here. That. So those are our land masses, and now we have there's a lighthouse up here, the Nubble Lighthouse. It's kind of small because it's in the distance. That's the left side of it. That's the right side of it. Make it as straight as possible. So let me use a ruler so I know I'm going to have this line be straight as possible. That's better. And the top. Kind of comes out here, comes out there. A little bit of a thickness right here. Put the railings in. Then, let's see, have the inside of it. Top of it. Most lighthouses have the same shape on the top. Like that. There, it's kind of open here. I kind of left it open right there. That way, that gives our basic lighthouse shape. But then there's a building just down here. There's a house over here, and we kind of make this a little bit more level land. There's a house right here. Side of it. Get the shapes right. couple windows in the front of there. Just basic idea. Okay, so we have our basic drawing. So now what I'll do is I'll grab my white paint. I usually start with white paint because everything mixes with white when you paint. Most of the time it does, at least. So I'm going to take some white, I'm going to take a little bit of yellow, and start painting in the sky. Sienna, that's a nice color. It's in the sky, all especially. It's a nice color all the time. I'm going to put a little black in my palette. A little bit of black. Grab my palette knife that I always use. Take a little bit of white. Touch of black. Come in here and start to fill in some of the sky. Actually, I probably want to put in the yellow area first, so when I touch the black, it doesn't turn green. Knock the knife off. So in the distance, we have some yellow sky here. I'll go around the shape of the lighthouse. Gonna rub it in there. More over there. There's two ways of doing this, really. You can paint the sky in and then let it dry and then draw in these buildings. Or you could just draw the buildings in and go around them. It's really up to you. Get some color in there. I didn't make it too bright yellow. I'll start to work in some first sienna. Yellow and white. Some color that gives us. If it's too brown, you can add a little bit of red, which is what I might do. Always use both sides of the knife. Because paint gets on the other side sometimes, you know, you waste that paint. Some paint right there because I'm gonna go over it. I just want to be able to see the sky through there. Right here. taken out. And a touch of red just to make it a little bit more orange in places. Yellow and red together. Red I'm using is a lot stronger than the yellow. So you have to use more yellow to compensate it. And you have a little bit of yellow in the sky. Right across there. Good. Work itself in. Now I'm gonna wipe the knife off because I want to put some grayer clouds in there. And mix it with some more white. If I use just straight black, it'd be too dark, so I need to mix it with some white. Come over there. Black and white. Darker cloud right here. White right in there to give it a little more of a transition-y look. Here. Lighter color. Top, I'm going to put a darker cloud. Turn it up here. Give it a little bit of contrast up there. I think I need a little bit more white in the palette to mix it with. Fight. And bring that across like that. I don't want to make it too strong, so I'm going to cut it back a little bit on the right side. So the pull of paint that's on their back. I don't want that area that strong like that. Cut it back. A little bit of red. Right here, I'm going to put a little bit of red, not too strong. A little bit of redness at the bottom of that cloud, just going to break it up a little. Blend that in a little bit more. You can see the canvas grain showing through right there, so what I want to do is kind of put a little white paint on there so that sort of blends it a little bit better. I guess that'll look as a blend. Where am I on time? Okay. A little bit more darker clouds. I'm going to push this back a little bit more. That's one thing I want to do. Like that. Sort of like a reverse stroke right there. little bit more dark cloud right in here. Sort of floating across there. And I'll take a little bit of light. Sort of work it in a little bit better. A little bit more. Down here, a little bit of a dark cloud. Balance it off a little. And a little bit something over here just to sort of break this area up a little bit. Work it in. A little bit better transition right there. All right, so I think we have a decent sky painted in here. Did a pretty good drawing. Light across there. Trying to make the horizon a little bit more blended, so because it makes it look a little further away. There's a little bit more depth in there. That's a horizon. That should be a blend a little bit better. Right, so I hope you guys enjoyed that. And next time I'll work on the land areas, these land areas, water. Final step will be to paint the lighthouse and the building here, house. A couple other buildings here I'll probably paint eventually. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time.